Hello everyone, today's project is the use of AXI DMA of Zynq processor. So let's start it. So first of all, we should know what is DMA. The DMA, which stands for direct memory access, is the process of transferring data without the involvement of the processor itself. Okay, that means we are giving the controlling authority to the DMA, so that processor, without the involvement of the processor, data can be transferred. So it is often used for transferring data to or from input output devices. A separate DMA controller is required to handle the transfer. That controller notifies the DSP processor that it is ready for a data transfer. The simplest uses of a DMA would be to transfer data from one part of the memory to another. However, a DMA engine can be used to transfer data from any data producer, example an ADC, to a memory, or from a memory to any data consumer like DSC. So this is the block diagram of how we are going to create our today's project. As we can see, this is a processor which is an ARM processor in our Zynq processor. This is the PS side of the Zynq processor and DDR memory in the PS side. And AXI DMA and the AXI data FIFO will be creating in the PL side. So today we'll transfer the data from processor to DDR with the help of AXI DMA. Here we can see that this is the AXI light bus, which will allow the processor to send the data to initiate transfer and control the data to the AXI DMA. These are the AXI 4 buses which will transfer the data only. So let's start our project. First of all, we go to create new. Next, we give it a name, AXI DMA. We'll just skip it. So, as we are using Zturn board, so we'll select this. Now we'll create block design, give it a name, AXI DMA. We'll add Zynq processor. We'll add AXI DMA. Okay, first of all, we'll create run block automation. So we'll select the board preset. Now we'll add the clocks. Now we'll click run clock connection automation. We'll select all of them. Okay, the design will be automatically created. Now we'll see the internal configuration of this DMA. So here it is, enable scatter gathering engine, enable controls, we'll disable it as we don't need them. Enable read channel, enable write channel. If you want to change these values, you can change. I will keep it as it is. I'll make it okay. Now we will not do anything else, we'll just run connection automation. So we'll click them okay, as AXI light bus will be connected to this PC. Okay, now we can see that these are AXI interconnect. and this is the DMA. So DMA is this AXI light is connected to the master AXI. Now slave AXI is connected to stream AXI, is connected to Zynq processor's GPIO pin, and the DMAXI AG is connected to this point, and this point is connected to the AXI HPGA. Now again we can see that so in MXI MM2S and MXI S2MM, these are left. So we'll again click on the run connection automation, we'll then tick. So this has been connected to the So we generate the layout. Now we can see all the ports we have connected. Now we add FIFO AXI data. Sorry, we'll add AXI stream FIFO. Now yes. Now we connect the S-axis data to the MM2S and S-axis S2M and connect the M-axis. Okay, now we connect the clock to the clock S-axis S-axis. Our project, our application will test the DMA in interrupt, so we'll activate the interrupts in the processing system. So we click here, go to interrupts, access PLP interrupts, placement interrupts. So we activate it. It has come. Now we add one block that is concrete. Concrete has come. So we'll use two interrupts. Then we connect it here. Second one will be directed here. The output will be directed to this interrupt. Now we have created our block design. Now let's verify it. Now the validation has been successful. Then we go to source. We'll generate output products. As you can see, it even if it's successful, okay, so we'll get it first. Okay, this stream has been generated. Now we'll just cancel it. Go to file, then export hardware, include bitstream. Okay, then go to file, launch SDK.
we can see that FSVL project has been updated. Now again, we will look at the definition project. Predefined hello world project that will print the hello world, okay. So we'll change this my code as in this code we have defined all the DMA parameters etc, and we have given the addresses with the functions, everything is there. So if you need this code, you please make comment on the comment section and send the code. Then in the SDK terminal, PVP, okay, port. Okay. So we run this. So after building this, so we'll see the output result. Here you can see that inputs are coming. So that's the result. So in this way you can use this DMA. It's the DMA directory code, the DMA XI DMA file. So if you like this tutorial, please subscribe my channel, like and share this video. Thank you so much. Please do like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you so much.